of class 11 have approached me and asked me doubts about the KVPV examination. So I thought that I will make a short video in which I shall share the notification issued by the Department of Science and Technology regarding the KVPV examination of 2021. So here is the notification on your screen. Now the first thing is that KVPY is Kishore Vaigyanik Prolsahan Yojana. This fellowship was introduced to develop interest among the students for studying basic sciences. So only if you are interested in pursuing your career in the field of basic sciences, you should apply for the KVPY examination. Anybody can apply. Even if you are planning to join in a medical or engineering stream after your plus two, then also you can appear for the KVPV examination. But the thing is, you will be awarded a fellowship only if you continue your studies in any one of the degree courses. That is, courses like BSc, BS, BStat, BMath, Integrated MSc or Integrated MS. So that is the one point which all of you should remember. Now the fellowship consists of 5,000 to 7,000 rupees per month once you qualify the examination and all the eligibilities that are required to get the fellowship. So the fellowship, I told you, is varies from rupees 5,000 to 7,000 per month, and contingency grants equivalent to 4 months of fellowship per annum. It is very clearly shown here. Now if you are studying in class 11, that is, there are three different types of streams for students to appear for the examination. Student belonging to any one of the three streams can appear for the KVPV examination. First one is stream A. You can see that it is written here, stream A. So all students who are now in plus one are in stream A. So it is very clearly mentioned here that if you have passed the board examination of 10th board examination or eligible, and now you have enrolled in class 11 as a science student, then you are eligible to appear for the KVPV examination of 2021. Then once you complete the plus two course, so if you qualify, you will be immediately notified when the examination is over and other formalities are completed. If you have qualified, you will be notified. But the fellowship will be awarded to you only if you join in any one of the courses which I had mentioned a little earlier. Courses like BSc, BStat, BMath, BAT, Integrated MSc or Integrated MS. Only if you join in any one of these courses, you will be eligible for receiving the fellowship, even if you qualify the KVPY examination. Next is for the students who are now in class 12, that is called stream S, stream SX, and the students in class 12, now in class 12, can also appear for the KVPV examination of 2021, and if they all satisfy the above mentioned criteria, they will also be receiving the fellowship. Now let us see what are the other general information given. So applications are already invited. The submission of the online applications form has already been started. Now it is, you should note that the application fee is ₹1,250 for general category students, and students belonging to SCST, it is reduced to ₹625. Now the other thing is that there is a computer based online version of the aptitude test that will be conducted at the selected sites. So the examination will be conducted at the selected sites, and it will be a computer based examination. It will be CBT, computer based test. Then if you want to appear for the mock tests are available, and for any detail you can contact, you can go to the website www.kvpy.iaac.ac.in. The website is also given here. I will share this notification to the relevant groups. Now see, the start of the online submission application started on 12th July. So the application form the online submission of the application form that has been started on the 12th. It will continue up to the 25th of the August. And then the KVPY aptitude test will be conducted on the 7th of November this year. So those are the major notifications. Now see, aptitude test will be held on Sunday, 7th November 2021 at various centers across the country. So another point is that there is no interview this year. Previously, the selection was based on the written test and interview. Now there is no interview because of the pandemic situation prevailing in our country. So the KVPY fellowship will be awarded solely on the basis of the aptitude test. So if you perform well in the aptitude test, you are eligible to get the KVPY fellowship. Now what are the advantages? One of the advantages is that you will be studying without the parents' help. Your parents need not help you to for your future studies. And then another important aspect of this fellowship is that there is an institute called ICER, which is also an institute set up by the government of India to only for the study of basic sciences. So if you are a KVPY fellow, admission to this this ICER, there is one ICER in Thiruvananthapuram in our state. So admission to the ICER is guaranteed if you are a KVPY fellow. The other methods of other ways by which you can enter into the ICER are either you should be a JEE advanced qualifier or you should have passed the examination conducted by ICER itself. ICER every year conducts an examination which you can appear after the your board examinations are over, after the completion of the plus two. So if you qualify in that examination also, you will be eligible for a seat in ICER. So these are the details which I wanted to tell you. So if you are interested, you go to the website and start applying from today itself. Thank you.